What can you say about your defense today, shutting out a top 10 opponent?
Well, coming into the game, we knew the key to beating them is you got to play great defense. And, you know, we've gotten better each week with our defense. They've worked really hard in practice to kind of clean up some of the things that were bothering us early in the year. But I can't say enough to hold this team, which was averaging 40 points a ball game, to hold them to nothing. It says a lot about our defensive coaches. You know, Jerry, Brandon, Damian, Matt, and Andy have done a great job. And then our guys to execute the game plan was tremendous.
Had a 13-0 lead at halftime, but I think Bethel still had about 18 minutes of time of possession in that first half. So how important were those two long drives in the second half, both double-digit plays, to just kind of lead out the clock?
Well, that was really important. And, you know, we dodged a bullet right away in the first half, the opening kickoff that we fumbled. And, you know, our guys hung in there right away, our defense hit, and then we put together a good long drive. And, you know, obviously, and we ran the football well when we needed to, and that was, I think, the key part of the ball game. You know, they were finding ways of stopping our passing game, but Kai Barber and our offensive line kind of took over in the second half.
You mentioned that fumble on the opening kickoff. You're able to get the stop, though, on the missed field goal and then take it right down the field and score. How important does that feel in a game like this?
Well, I mean, momentum is so important in a game like that, and our guys, you know, to stop them like we did and then turn around and go right down the field said a lot about the kind of football team we have.
Had some skill player injuries today, but Robbie's able to step up. What's it like to see him blossoming?
Well, he gets better every week, and, you know, I'm proud of him. He's worked really hard and has become a great receiver. Unfortunately, I think we probably lost Andrew Van Erp, who's our leading receiver. It looks like he's probably tore his ACL, so we're keeping our fingers crossed and it's not, but our young guys stepped up today.
What do we expect going forward into St. Thomas week now?
Well, we'll prepare like we do every week. Obviously, we know the importance of that game, and we'll have a great week of preparation, be ready to go next Saturday.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
What can you say about the aggressiveness of the secondary out there today, breaking up a lot of passes?
So all week we knew that they were a physical team. They're going to come out and hit us in the mouth. So all week we just preached physicality, aggressiveness, and even throughout the game we just showed that from our defensive linemen to our linebackers to our secondary. So it was awesome to see. Obviously we gave up 0 points, so that's what we were going for.
I think after that first drive, sort of that sudden change, what did that do to set the tone for the game after?
After the fumble?
The fumble on the kickoff, yep.
Yep, so defense was ready to go. We thought our offense was going to get the ball and drive down the field right away, but obviously we fumbled it, unfortunately. But defense was ready. We were positive. As soon as the fumble happened, all the defense came together as a unit. We said, let's go, let's get this stop. And then, fortunately, they missed the field goal. And then we just kept that momentum going all game. So,
what is the statement of this team shutting out a top 10 opponent?
It's huge. It's huge for us. They were number 6 coming in. We were number 4. It was a big game. And for our defense to show up like that and for our offense to put those drives together when we needed it, it was huge for our whole team. It was huge for just going into the next week against St. Thomas and then just all the way throughout the whole season. So, yeah, it was awesome.
What will this week of preparation be like preparing for certainly the biggest game of the year by a lot of standards?
Yep. Earlier this week, this game was the biggest game of the year. Now next week, the same thing. It's the biggest game of the year. We're going to prepare the same way as we do every week. We're going to attack every day with a purpose and with a focus. And then we're going to go out on Saturday, and hopefully we can get the same result. That's what we're looking for.
Awesome. Thank you.
All right, Robbie, we talked the other day about this game. You sounded really excited, and you certainly produced 9 catches, over 180 yards, a touchdown. I mean, how's that?
Oh, man, it feels good. Like I said, we've just been practicing all week, you know, the game plan. Our coaches do a really good job of, you know, just giving us a great game plan to come out here and just do what we do. Like I said, we knew they were going to run a lot of man coverage, meaning a lot of one-on-one chances for me to go out there and make plays. And I told you I wasn't worried about it. I know my abilities, so we were out there and got the job done, so it feels good.
Talk about your touchdown catch. What'd you see? How'd you get open? And then the adjustment to make a nice play in the end zone.
So we had a double post called. You know, like I run a post on the outside, TJ runs post on the inside. When I was on the outside, my guy kind of just left me, so I just kind of kept it skinny, just running straight. Jackson saw me, aired it out there, and Like, it was a little backside a little bit, but I just needed to catch the ball. I'm in the end zone, so just catch it, and that's what I did.
How important is it for you to step up? You know, you see a teammate in Earp go down, and you're able to step up in that second half, first drive with five big catches and a touchdown as well.
It feels great, man. I know Earp, Andrew, he works real hard, you know. It kind of sucks seeing my guy go down, but we face a lot of adversity. Next man up, you know, we're all out here. We're all capable of what we can do, and so it feels good. We can get it done for him.
How rewarding is it as an offense to have those two really long drives in the second half and just bleed the clock out and get a win here today?
Yeah, whenever it's fourth quarter and we just got to pound in, keep getting first downs, that's the best feeling. You know, victory formation is the best formation. So once we get in there, we know we're good. Kai Barber did a great job just pounding the ball, so we need that. Our O-line did a great job, too, blocking all game. O-line, hats off to those guys and our defense. Our defense played a great game, shutting them out, so we need that week by week.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Robbie.
Thank you.